Live from the big circular area in Central Texas that is called Austin, where we sing bawdy Cockney songs and say, "Hey, Big Hurt, I lost my senses, taste, and smell." It's going to be a great night. Now, put away your big beefy beeve and try to think about baseball. Because here are your hosts, Brian, Mr. Chernobyl Brushwood, and Justin, no nickname, Robert Young!
Ahoy, sir. Ahoy, sir. Ahoy, sir. Ahoy, sir. What's that over there?
I don't know.
It's probably a boy, sir.
A boy, sir.
It's me, a boy.
Okay.
I'm lost.
Yeah, you wandered into a sketch, kid. This may not be appropriate.
I'm just a little British boy, and I am.
You're a British boy who wandered into our sketch.
Indeed, I did.
At the beginning of our show.
To be fair, I'm the kind of heightened character for which is very common in British comedy.
Yeah.
Makes you think.
Think about what?
I didn't know that we could murder characters.
Of course you can.
What's the
fucking point of them?
Reads 7:04 p.m. to 7:05 p.m.
That's a thing for a while my wife had to do, because I will just come up with, I'm the most annoying person to be married to.
I don't believe that. Give me an example.
I feel like competitively, I would rate.
Challenging.
Because all I do is look to torture the one that I love, and I just come up with characters and stuff. And so, like, there are times where there would be a character so fucking annoying.
Right.
That Ashley would just, she would have the character gun.
Yeah.
And just be like, we're done. Just so you know, I thought it was funny enough that I did a theatrical conceit to pull out the character gun. So you're validated. So the thing that you really wanted is now there. It got to die a noble death.
Sure.
But if I hear you do that fucking voice one more second, I will actually murder you.
No specifics, but do you think it's more the character that is ruining your marriage, or the timing of the use of the character?
Oh, there is no tool that I have not used in that toolbox. Like, it is every element of it. It is the annoyingness of the voice, the kind of character it is, when I'm doing it. Like, again, I'm a terrible person to be married to.
What's a pretty good character that you do that in general is well received?
It's hard because she doesn't laugh at anything, because she knows that if she laughs at a thing, I'll never stop doing it.
And I have noticed that she does the best move ever, which is she drapes her hair over her face to hide whether or not she's smiling.
Yeah.
It is.
Oh, no. People are pointing out, because it has apparently become, it has spilled out into the internet that she greatly despises Steve McTillitooter. The laser disc aficionado.
Yeah, I am convinced that this might be a timing issue. Like, if you were to, say, be calling Spectrum and do it entirely in the voice of Steve McTillitooter, and she was just hearing the one side of the conversation, still no?
She would spin kick the phone out of my hand. and she would do it so hard that it would comically fly out of my hand through a window over the hills and plains of America beyond the Atlantic Ocean and land comically in the River Thames in London. That is how hard she would like to end that concept.
Okay. Right. So soft yes.
She doesn't like me or my voices. No, she likes me. I think it's her trying to reconcile the fact that, like, she's with somebody for whom has a catch. right? And great, thankfully it's not a disease.
What?
Like this isn't what? Like a young adult novel or anything. What? I'm not an unfunctional alcoholic. Like, you know, I don't have a substance abuse problem. I have one problem, and that is I can't stop doing really annoying voices that push the edge of her sanity.
Yeah, but you only have the one annoying voice and you've given it up, right?
No, I'm constantly in the lab.
What?
I think every day about how I can annoy my wife with another voice.
Help me understand here. Maybe I'm making breakfast for you because I appreciate you.
So you're Ashley.
You.
Yeah. I'm just workshopping.
Yeah. Sure. Yeah. I'm making vegan eggs and flipping vegan pancakes.
I'm Lord Snake. I'm Lord Snake and I want eggs.
Okay.
I want eggs now. Cook my eggs faster. I'm the Lord Snake. I got a snake for a face and I got eggs in my belly as soon as you're done cooking them. Cook them now.
Get the gun. Get the character gun.
I got to take notes.
Justin, and that's off the top of the dome.
Yeah.
Right? That's,
Justin, I just
I'm
like to
I'm
thank
like
you.
I'm like a freestyle rapper for annoying characters.
Justin, I want to thank you because I'm learning so much more for my marriage from you. So, baby, guess what? We got some new things to try out.
Yeah. Lord Snake
in the bedroom?
Yeah.
Like, where are we headed here?
Yeah. Bryce, what's our first topic?
Our first topic!
Brian did a weird show.
It wasn't supposed to be a weird show. In fact, some people might just call it the show that I did for 25 years. But it
your,
was
your, Matt, back, your stage show.
Back in the mists of time, Brian Brushwood was not an internet personality. He was a touring magician.
Yeah.
At which point, you're also the narrator.
No. I was going to do sound effects and okay.
Writing his Toyota Camry.
All right.
He got to
Whoa,
a gig.
Oh, boy.
Well, I do believe this is a university somewhere north of Dallas.
And in those days, he would do his show really well, ending it with his big applause line.
Hooray for me. I'm great.
And lo, and lo, the 18-year-olds who were compulsorily made to come to the show did cheer, for they enjoyed Brian Brushwood, and he would go and get a six-pack of Miller Lights and drink them all before he got on the plane, usually saving one or two that he would drink right as he woke up.
Jiminy criminy.
It's too on the nose.
I'm an omniscient narrator.
doing shows post-COVID, like the weirdest thing about the show is that it was a completely normal show.
Yeah.
No masks, a fully attended audience, like 500 people there. It was me, Nate Staniforth, Dan Martin. It was classic us at our best.
And this has been a show you guys have done for many years, right?
I think 8, 9, 10 years running. I mean, it's bonkers.
At this point, this is, you know, again, and I was doing it as a joke, but for real, like your entire year used to be packed out with gigs.
Right.
Now in this incarnation of your career, from my knowledge of your schedule, that's it. That is the only thing where, you know, it's Happy New Year. You know, you have one gig and it is there.
Yeah. And I'm not ashamed to own the fact that when you do 80 minutes of material, there's like a sliding scale where it's like there's some that's always chrome like polished that require the fewest number of props. It's all at the tip of your brain at all times. And then there's increasing. The farther down the roster you get, the more you have to like make sure that valves haven't desiccated and that props are rebuilt and all that stuff. So it's like, right now I've got a solid 45 minutes where I could drop everything and just go do the show, as we saw at RTX, right?
Yeah.
But so we go out to do this show, and the thing I did not expect was, it's good to see you, Dan. It's good to see you, Nate. and we're getting ready, and Nate says, Brian, I'm nervous. And I was like, why? You're better than me. You're an excellent magician. Everybody respects you. You have sincerity. You have unique storytelling chops. You are one of the great master craftsmen of magic. Why are you, what are you scared of? And he's like, well, it's just been so long. And then I froze and I thought, it has been a while.
Wait, hold on. If you're worried, fuck.
That is literally what happened. And meanwhile, Dan Martin, like top of the line chrome polish worker every single day, five times. Like, he's like, excuse me, I need to take a short break. Goes off and does a Zoom show on stage, then comes back on stage.
Jesus. Right.
Like he's feeling none of the fear. But it's like I hear Nate say that, and it was like a creeping infection that came into me. And I was just like, do I really know how to eat fire? Do I know how to do any of this? It was a good show, though, but a weird sensation. It has been 15, 20 years since I have felt those nerves.
Is that still important to you, being able to go out there and prove that you can do it? Like are you that kind of a mechanical live performer? Because that is so much of magic. Is not just getting up there and being there in the moment, but also making sure, like, timing really fucking matters in that kind of business.
I'm not going to say I'm going to remain addicted forever, but I'm still addicted
right now.
To proving myself over and over and over again. I look forward to, you know.
Anytime you can
75 years from now when I don't care.
When you don't care.
Yeah.
No, but you're always going to do it. You're always going
to
do it.
Dude, I'm stoked. To be honest, it actually really... Like, I had this flash of, like, I wish Justin was here and we could do the all-set-up magician. I wish we could do the two personal mentalists. It was great. It was a great experience.
You did throw out an 11th-hour Hail Mary, like, the night before you went on, where you're like, hey, you're just floating it out there. Who would like to get on a flight to Florida?
I mean, it would be free to me and just work you would do.
What? By the way, though, he did pitch it to me as, hey, let's go to Disney. What do you say we go to Disney?
Oh, my God.
He did not pitch it as, hey, would you like to get up on stage and perform?
Yes, I did.
Here.
I pulled up in my van and I said, hey, talented person, would you like some candy?
Bryce, what's the next topic?
Daredevil on Disney Plus.
Oh, so it worked?
Brian, I'm going to need for you to just trust me because I'm going to go through a bunch of topics.
Mm-hmm.
And I know with so many of them, you're going to want to go off on a tangent, but just follow me, okay?
No Rocky Balboas.
So Daredevil, the Marvel character.
Yeah.
What is Daredevil's iconic power?
Being blind.
Which means?
He's great at everything else.
Because all of his other senses get?
Better.
Heightened, right? Better, sure.
Better.
Let's go with better. Put a pin in that. I go to a gym every morning. Thank you.
Admirable this is restrain. Harder than I thought.
Admirable restraint.
Yeah, nice.
In that gym situation, it's a guided workout. You've got a bunch of people on treadmills right next to each other. Put a pin in that.
Mm.
I fart a lot. All right?
Oh, you're testing them now.
I fart a lot.
Yeah, sure.
And especially because I like
what
to work out early
what
in the morning.
What is a lot?
When I used to run by myself... Just around my neighborhood in Oakland or in Austin.
The cops would show up.
Because I was farting.
Because you're rolling
cold. We're getting a lot of reports and there's some farts in the neighborhood.
Did you bring it down a little bit, sir?
When I would go running by myself, it would often be like a joke to me how much I would fart while I was running.
Sure.
If I may.
Please, go ahead.
I just picture you running by yourself, and every time you fart, you begin to laugh louder and louder.
Yes.
Until finally, you're like the Joker. You're like,
you're not far off.
Okay.
You're not far off.
It's side question.
Yeah.
Do you run like Tom Cruise when you're when
T-1000. Yeah.
Okay.
Like yeah.
Cool.
Like
sure.
Like totally locked elbows.
Yes.
And knife fingers.
There we go.
Like as
you.
Fast as I
just,
possibly
just
can.
Just for the image for me and farting at the same time.
Less marathon man, more methane man.
At the time that I was doing it outside, I didn't know if it made me go faster.
It was ruining
the planet. Imagine that there's some element of propulsion there.
Yep.
But now I'm indoors. I'm in this gym, right? And so I get nervous. And one time, I farted. I had a particularly farty pizza the night before.
Was it advertised that way?
No.
Should be.
But it is forever known in my mind. It's good, though. But it makes you fart.
They put beans on it?
Makes me fart. No, it was just the crust. I don't know what was in the bread, but it was something that made me rip ass. And, like, this is, like, guided by a coach at this gym, right? And so...
At the gym advised you to eat.
No.
Got
just,
it.
Just
run. All right. No. I'm with you.
I had eaten the farty pizza the night before. Wake up early in the morning, go to this gym, and the coach, yeah, there's music playing and shit. And so like they're usually pretty good at like turning their mic up and down if they got to guide somebody or something. But I ripped ass, and they're walking right behind me, and they're like, all right, everybody, we're about to go, Jesus! So just so you know where I'm coming from.
Yeah.
With this, I'm worried that I'm going to fart, and everyone's going to notice.
Yeah.
Something else.
There's more.
I mean, I don't know that you have to be worried since you definitely did that.
I did it. No,
yeah.
And I was horrified. I was mortified by it, right? Like, it's thank God I have a comedy podcast where I can monetize this shit. Like, if I just had to sit on it in shame, like, I would kill myself.
All right, a little morose, but okay. Yeah, I'm following you.
The other thing is...
Oh, my God.
That this gym...
on the other cheek.
This gym... has a lot of women that are there. And
sure.
For whatever you would think of gender norms, it is more embarrassing for me to rip a fucking putrid fart in front of a woman than it is a man.
It's just
the way I was raised.
Even in yoga.
I don't go to fucking yoga because of that.
Okay.
Because I fart and fall asleep. Without fail at fucking yoga. I actually like yoga, but I can't do it.
Right.
God
because
damn.
All I do is fucking rip ass and fall asleep. I'm the worst person. I probably enjoy it the most, but I can't do it. Anyway.
Time out.
Yes.
Time out.
Go.
Justin.
Yeah.
Hey, Brian. Please don't follow any of the threads I'm going to lay before you.
Oh, my gosh.
I'm going to open some doors. We're going to be in a place. Whatever you do, don't touch anything.
Yeah.
The place is a fucking Chinese buffet.
Yeah. And if I didn't tell you that.
Close. And
that
close.
Would have been the rest of the
yes.
show.
Yes. Yes.
Right?
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
Yep.
All right.
Brings me to Monday. I show up to my gym. And I find that unlike most days, not only is there... a woman on the treadmill next to me. There's a deaf woman on the treadmill next to me.
Now,
conundrum.
I do feel like.
Who, just like Daredevil.
Oh, no.
If she cannot hear.
Jiminy Criminy.
I'm worried
you're
that the rest of her senses.
I think I have one lifeline that I get to use. I get one lifeline. How did you know she was deaf?
Because the coach was coming up and giving her ASL, and she had a special card, so she would know exactly what the workout was. And then every time there was a thing, and good on the coaches, they were giving her all the signals and stuff like that. So they were taking care of her.
This is when you high road me. This is when I get high roaded. All right,
I'm just saying.
It's fine.
Oh, do you want me to? I'm sorry. Do you want me?
No, I have no moves. I'm a piece of shit.
Why the fuck do you think I told you to just go along with it?
So have you done it? Have you farted in front of this woman yet?
Bryce, the night before.
Oh, my gosh.
I had a family-sized portion of potato soup.
Oh,
no.
Oh, no.
With the cheese. With the cheese.
And the chives.
And I'm on the treadmill.
Oh,
and
no.
And I'm looking over, and I'm like, I swear to fuck. Like, now, because what's worse? That I'm running on the treadmill, I rip a fart, and now I'm looking her dead in the eyes, seeing if she notices.
Right.
Pause. I literally don't know the right answer. Like, this is the Kobayashi Maru of farting on a treadmill. Like, do you wave and be like I'm gonna
fart now.
Yeah. I do believe it's like, you know. I'm sorry, you know, don't go on camera. It's fine.
So I'm trying to hold it. I'm doing my best, man. I'm trying. I am controlling core muscles that I didn't know I had. Like, it is. And meanwhile, I'm trying to still get a workout. I'm trying to still run. And I'm going. Like,
Nice.
I'm like, all right, let's hit a push. Ah, let's go to an all out. Ah! Big gasser.
Yeah. So, who reacts? Who doesn't? And in what order?
Brian, I wish I could give you an 80s ending, but we're going to have to end like a 90s movie where you're just going to have to, like, I look over at her and I think she probably...
Wait. A smash cut to black? like, well...
Who knows? It's like the ending of The Sopranos.
Right?
Yeah. Like,
when do you go back? When's your next session... Where she'll be there? Is she like normally?
I mean,
class?
I don't know. Like she just kind of showed up. So who knows the next time she's gonna be there?
Okay, I'm not insisting.
She's never coming back. She is never coming.
Not
back.
Insisting.
Yeah.
But I am suggesting.
Yeah.
Should you find it funny, Brett, Bryce, and me will all come to your next session.
Yes.
On the same day.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
We will walk behind you with deference.
Yeah.
Wearing T-shirts that say. Fart Patrol. Just to see if anybody reacts.
I love that band. Yeah.
What's happening here? Please
talk
on microphone.
Hold on. Wait, no. Bonnie's showing me ASL for fart. So the ASL for fart is that you have like you make one hand into a butthole and then you just... Go,
you like feather out,
jut your hand out.
Because I think shit is you grab your thumb and you plunk like that.
Gotcha.
And then whereas doing like jazz shit.
Yeah.
Farts,
well, now I know.
Farts
now
are just
I know.
Jazz shit.
Now I know. The next time that I fart next to her, I will be like, Ming, meh.
You think she won't know? You think she won't know? I think she knew.
Yeah. Do you think she knew?
She knew.
I mean.
I guess really this is a whole story to get to ask this question. Is Daredevil for real? Bryce, next topic!
Also, write us your thoughts.
The website wonder.
So we have an email address for Great Night. greatnightpod@gmail.com. Please email us there. And I got a message the other
Let
day.
Us know, is Daredevil for real?
Is Daredevil for real? I got a message to today from Alicia. 2 days ago, excuse me, from Alicia. You know,
super fan.
A super fan, I mean, replied even. Wrote and replied before I got to follow up. Do you mind if I just read this? I know that we don't normally do like...
We encourage people to send in their high thoughts. We read interesting questions. We ask people whether or not Daredevil is for real.
Maybe. We'll find out one day.
What did Alicia have for us?
Yeah.
Alicia writes, Hi, E.
E.
H-I-E. not capitalized.
Oh, got it. Okay.
Hope you are fine. I just wanted to do a follow-up on the last mail, which I sent some days back.
Uh-oh.
Oh, fuck, man. We missed that email from Alicia.
It was from...
That does sound like something we would do.
It was from 5 days back.
I swear to God, if this is about a fart she smelled...
All right. Move on, Bryce. Come on.
All right. Do you, by any chance, need help with anything related to website development or NVIDIA? If so, please let me know. If you want, I can share some of our work with you. We have helped more than 434 clients in 39 countries.
Hold on.
She's such a good fan.
How many more?
Somebody picks the number 434.
Yeah.
Actually, they have 435, but they're like, no. More than 434.
Yeah, right?
Okay.
Yeah. Or it was 14 after they said spark it. Math joke.
Yeah. Right. Alicia continues.
Move on.
Let us connect on Skype/WhatsApp and discuss it in detail. No capitalization, by the way, in any of this.
Tell me we're about to call her.
Let us take your domain, the Big Hard Dick Club. In the top level of Google. So
hold on. All right. So
and that came to what email, Bryce? What email did that come into?
GreatNightPod@gmail.com is where this was sent by Miss Alicia.
And one more time, Alicia. That final sentence.
Let us take your domain, the Big Hard Dick Club, in the top level of Google.
First of all,
I mean, imagine what a basement dwelling the Big Hard Dick Club is now.
Yeah,
right.
Right. It could be elevated to the top level of
Google. Yeah. I'm asking, I know where I stand, but just to be clear, are you a member of the Big Hard Dick Club?
Apparently we are. We own it. We own the domain. That's why they send it to our podcast email.
That is what I am assuming.
Yeah.
I am assuming
Brian, I'm not just the founder. I'm also a client.
There we go. I'm also a member.
Can we call them right now? Do they have a Skype?
No, that's just a scam. It's just a scam.
Yeah.
I just want some scammer on the other side of the planet to say, yes, hello, I want to elevate Big Hard Dick Club.
So yeah, we don't want to go Kit Boga. We don't want to jack his keys.
It's an email. They didn't send any contact. I'd have to reply and
And then they would send a WhatsApp or Skype or whatever.
But do we? I was not aware of this domain. Justin was not aware of it. Brian, is this a domain that we have?
Listen, I have something I
actually, when Bryce sent this to us today, and I was racking my brain on like. It doesn't sound beyond us to register the URL Big Hard Dick Club.
Yeah. Like that. The Big Hard Dick Club.
The Big Hard Dick Club.
See, and that would be our move because we were too late to get Big Hard Dick Club.
I bet you Big Hard Dick Club is.
Right.
Bryce, can you just look up Big Hard Dick Club?
Yeah, just real.
He's doing a who is right now.
We're doing it here.
It's what?
BigHardDickClub.com is not available. Let's add the there and see if there's anything there. It looks like Hover does, in fact, have the BigHardDickClub.com as expired. So maybe
at some point,
first of all,
we bought
fuck
it.
You, Hover.
Yeah,
this shit may be a little bit aged, but it is not expired.
It's still big.
It's still hard.
And it's still a dick.
Club.
Club.com.
I'm telling you, all of us walking behind Justin wearing Bart Patrol. Come on.
Yeah.
Yeah, wait a minute. Hold on. But we just tried .com. Have we just Googled the Big Hard Dick Club and just seen like whether it went to a .biz or a .pizza?
It's a series of young right, adult
EK,
knowledge.
EK is melting in the back here.
Yes.
Out of curiosity.
Yeah,
get on Brett's mic. Ladies and gentlemen, EK Weaver.
Hey. Gonna be at San Japan this weekend.
Yeah, check him out, San Japan.
Yep.
Go ahead. Just out of curiosity, I looked up fartpatrol.com and it leads to the McElroy brothers.
Oh, thank God we got them some press.
Yeah. Thanks, EK.
Bryce, can you Google Big Hard Dick Club?
Yeah, well, it says, Google says here, it looks like there aren't many great matches for your search.
Okay.
We've got allthecom.info. We've got Wellness Forever Big Hard Dick Long Island condos for sale.
All right. Put a pin in that one. Put a pin in that one.
Exactly, yeah.
End of list.
All right, Google gave us... Bryce, do me a favor. Do not show the screen. Just show your face.
Sure.
And click images there.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Interesting. Looks like there aren't any matches. Maybe I had save serve off.
I called it. I've been explaining it to the missus for years. Yeah. There ain't no such thing. It's like trying to find a Sasquatch. That's why there's only normal sized.
Mm-hmm.
Medium.
Yep.
Hard.
Inches by inches what?
Gosh, like
let's all say it at the same time.
All right. At the same time. Three, two, one. That was my guess.
Okay, that was my guess.
All right. Great. That was my guess.
I thought we were all gonna say it at the same time. Yeah.
It was three or two or one.
It was three, two, or one.
Nobody else. I guess I was just by myself.
It's a lot.
Yeah. Yep.
Thanks, gang.
Oh, shut up.
Hey, we are the Fart Club.
We're the Fart Club, damn it.
Patrol.
BioCow is linking us to the Medium Hard Dick Club.
Oh, wow.
Turns out it's not there yet.
The flops, they call them on the street.
Anyway.
Brian, you ever get a case of the flops?
No. Well, okay. Okay.
Did at the show.
The way the mineral hardness scale works.
Did you say the mineral hardness?
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
Yeah. No. It's like diamond is the hardest.
Gotcha.
Diamond is forever.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay. Uh huh.
Scratch.
Girl's
anything.
Best friend.
Yeah. Right. Okay. Okay.
The club.
Now I know why. A fingernail less hard than a diamond.
According to science, sure.
Okay, but still enough to, like, you know, yeah, take a chunk out of a Dove bar.
Yep.
So there.
Yeah.
Wouldn't that be like medium hardness? The flops.
You know, you're just like, they're kind of moving like those wacky, wavy, inflatable tube men out in front of a car dealership.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Flops were
they're still moving.
That's too soft. That ain't medium. That ain't medium.
They're like
that's gone full soft, my friend.
That's not full soft if it's standing up.
No. Medium. Medium is
medium's
a
what?
Candle. Candle. Wax.
There it is.
So we have diamond up top.
Yep.
Then conundrum below that.
Corundum, masonry build, drill bit. Topaz, quartz, steel nail. Now we're getting comfy. Knife, glass.
Wow, fingernail was really low. So what you said was a medium thing is actually very low. It was the second lowest on that scale.
Oh, Bonnie, I'm sorry.
How often are you hitting with the fingernail? I'm so glad. I'm so glad and yet so upset that I'm facing you and not Bonnie.
Yeah.
I'm looking at you and in
whatever.
Respect. Get to the mic.
Okay,
Bonnie.
All right. How often am I hitting the fingernail?
Hold on.
I have an answer.
Go, get a mic.
If the question is how often am I hitting the fingernail?
Scoot.
The answer is not even one is too many.
Okay.
lay us down the fingernail law, Bonnie.
Yeah.
Bonnie Brushman here is
in fact, drop
here.
A hip hop beat.
Well,
boom, 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 boom. I don't know. Okay.
Not you. He was okay.
There was like. I've heard, ever since I became aware of sexual activity, the word a semi, right?
Describing an
erection's level of hardness, right?
Yeah.
Sure.
And I was just like, for way too long in my adult history, in sexual history, and finally one day I go, why do they call it a semi? This is not... I'm a semi truck.
Yeah.
Hard.
Correct.
It's like you're saying semi, and it's like just not like a semi truck. So I did not understand.
So
that
if you experienced in your life a semi erection,
right?
You'd be like, this doesn't have truck nuts.
Like, that is what I like am this, saying. It was, this isn't this way too.
This isn't narrated by Dennis Leary.
Exactly.
Yes.
Yeah. This isn't trying to race Marty McFly at the end of the trilogy.
So, anyways, on the hardness scale, apparently. Let's take it over to the
okay,
semi.
I was gonna, there's a pressing.
Go ahead.
I do a performance.
Yeah. All right, here we go.
That's so, too bad because I was watching your face the whole time.
So, like, you get down
Brian.
To the semi here. It
way
it's
below
down here
the
by talc.
Below apparently. The graph, she's.
All right, pointing. So yeah. The lowest level of Mohs hardness scale is talc.
Right.
Right. It's like talcum powder.
Yeah.
Right.
You have a fingernail, two above that, a penny, one above that, a glass. A knife/glass plate is around in the middle.
Maybe
diamonds up top.
Maybe like if we throw semi onto this chart somewhere, maybe it's what do you think?
Calcite or fluorite?
Calcite.
Wow. Only a little bit harder than the fingernail at 2.5.
I would say it's above fingernail. The way I would describe a semi. Yeah, I would say it's above. It's above that.
Anyways, the point is I'm dumb and it was really funny. So,
ladies and gentlemen, Bonnie Brushwood. Let's get a big round of applause.
Hey, I try not to pull too many audibles, but we did mention how diamonds are forever. They're the hardest that they can be, which reminded me of a certain text conversation that I don't know if we've spoken of on the air. Or was that a Patreon?
Go on.
I don't know
we
what you're thinking
rig
about.
Shit!
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, we did cover that on
we covered it on the on the Patreon. We can do it again.
No.
Oh, yeah.
That's a fine
Let's
tease.
Go. Yeah.
Like that's why people should go to patreon.com/greatnight.
/greatnight. Oh. Yeah, yeah.
We have one more thing to talk about.
Well, no, we're going to go back to it.
Okay.
Yeah, we're going to go back to it. This is a new format. Remember, we're not being precious about the format. We're doing whatever the hell we want.
I love it.
Yeah, patreon.com.
Don't go all semi on us.
Already in.
Patreon.com/greatnight is where you need to go. Go ahead and get that episode. But as a tease, I got a text from my co-host on the We're Not Wrong podcast, Jen Briney, who was at Podcast Movement in Dallas.
Center of all things podcast.
I mean, effectively, it is the top podcasting industry convention. And she goes, hey, I'm talking to this guy. And he's like, the Diamond Club is a bunch of douchebags. And I'm like,
what?
And I'm like, what the fuck are you, a douchebag? Like,
that's
like our Diamond Club?
A douche is below talc.
Yeah, right? And I'm like,
for diamonds.
I have no idea who the fuck we would have pissed off. Like, that's ridiculous. And then she's like, yeah, no, it's you guys. And I'm like, well, what the fuck? What did we do? And then she goes, did you guys rig the podcast awards in 2015? To which I send her back in all caps.
We did rig shit.
And then afterwards, that's us. So if you want to hear all of the backstory behind that and where that went, go ahead and listen to the Patreon episode.
Bonus episodes.
Do not
better and better.
Do not celebrate.
Do not celebrate.
Do not celebrate.
Yeah, that would be against the spirit of patreon.com/greatnight.
Bryce, final topic.
Final topic.
It's not an A+, man.
We're running low on time. Let's go ahead and
get to the game. No, I swear to God.
No.
This is not going to be another Bilbo Baggins.
What do you think? I don't know. You want to run up the library steps or... hey, what's Adrian up to?
No.
Oh, my God.
Nope.
You want to take her to the zoo?
No.
Huh?
No.
Huh?
I wish I had a massive fart loaded in the chamber right now.
I was on C-SPAN.
You're on C-SPAN. That's
I
fun.
Was, yeah. In fact, I completed a thing I thought was unique to me, which was being on C-SPAN and having a cameo in a metal music video within the same week, because I was also in the Callous Dowboys video, the elephant man in the room. But then somebody from C-SPAN, who I tagged, said, sure about that?
And
then and then showed the receipts of D. Snyder like testifying to Congress.
On C-SPAN.
And I'm like, I got spanned, dog. I mean,
not for nothing, but if you have to join a club, pretty good club.
I mean, me and D. I was on C-SPAN. It was an absolute honor, and I think in the original version of this we were going to do a week ago, you had thoughts and ideas and memories of it, but I think we've kind of moved past that phase.
To be honest, I would really just love to hear general impressions and what it meant to you to do it, because in general, fuck me, I don't know that I've ever cheered harder at a 3-hour-old recorded video that I watched alone since I first discovered pornography. But it was like
that will certainly transform the next time I hear cheering in that shed.
Yeah. Fuck yes. No, it was truly remarkable because you set out your stated goal when you started doing the jury podcast is you said there's no more difficult challenge than pulling off a one mic show.
Yes.
Somebody's ability to sit and speak in complete sentences for hours on end and to answer questions coherently is the world's most dangerous game.
It is
here
hard.
You
it is
were
very hard. Yeah.
Fucking after 10 years of practicing it, doing it at a premier arena in front of all of America. Mm-hmm. And then they bring in the pitcher and it turns out they're playing softball. And I just sit there and I watch Justin go one after another, knocking them through the park, ending in, there was one moment that I truly wanted to share. The very last question of the entire thing was
so good.
When I stood up alone in the shack and started clapping was Justin handling this caller.
Okay, comment and question. Donald Trump is the person that was elected and told and tried to dismantle the policies that Obama had put in place to fight pandemics. Then he lied to the American people about, it's a hoax.
Pause. Look at that poise.
That
steely-eyed gaze.
No, that's
a motherfucking pro who's waiting for. Go ahead. What are you gonna do?
That might as well be the Apple Beach Ball.
it's perfect though.
But she clearly has something scripted. She's gonna hit you hard with something.
No. This, if you actually want to go behind inside the actor studio here, this is me just waiting for the open end to grab and throw. So I know she's gonna go. I know she's not like if I try to grab something early, she's gonna try and talk over me.
Yep.
I need for the last moment that is gonna go. And in the meanwhile, I'm trying to find.
On the other hand, she very clearly is prepared with something. There might be a trap around the corner.
Well, no, I mean, it's C-SPAN, so, like, they're very lonely, and look.
Play into the bit, Justin! Play into the bit!
All I'm going to say is, if your parents are really into politics and they're calling into C-SPAN, please call them more often. They would really like to talk to you.
Okay.
He'd ever seen. He came and told the American people after that interview with the guy who interviews presidents that it's a hoax.
Pause. By the way, cool virus. Power move. Bored host scratching his nose.
Yeah, I was also very hungover.
Okay, go ahead.
Here, and I mean, how are we going to take it higher if our leader is a liar?
Okay.
Oh, pause.
There,
what an end tag with a rhyme and a line.
Yep.
You got.
Exact. Yeah. About 2 years late on the call because Donald Trump's not the president anymore. But Pedro, he's the real Chad here, because like that dude does nothing but take calls on Washington Journal every fucking day, and so he knows exactly where she is losing
like
her breath and is just like thank you. But I don't suspect that many people who are on this slot, which is Saturday mornings, they do a podcast spotlight, so they have political podcast people on. I did not get the sense from him while we were on the show that a lot of people want to take these calls. A lot of people are, they want to hear.
They like, reluctantly they, yeah. are like, okay, I guess. Yeah,
the call gets played, and then he starts talking to them, and that's it. I established early on that I wanted to interact with these people.
Yes.
And so he is now just stopping her at the end
because
of this.
Because he knows the secret, which
that
is
I'm, that I'm
humans
going
have to,
go. To
breathe. And yeah. so detecting that she's breathing, he says, goodbye, click.
Bring it home, baby.
There we go.
Mr. Young, anything to that?
Boy, 2020, what a crazy year, right? I'm glad we're in 2022.
Before we let you go, how can people find your podcast?
You can search for Politics, Politics, Politics on any platform for which you get your podcast. Justin Robert Young is my name.
My favorite is I believe that is word for word your literal advice to anybody at any level in politics to answer any question
yes.
to.
Yeah. Barry, isn't that crazy, huh?
Hey, Big Hurt.
Bryce, we got a game?
Hi, we do have a game.
We did C-SPAN. Look at that.
Look at that.
Nailed it. High five.
Oh, that's so good. So good.
Hello, everybody. So we got a new game here. This is from our friends BioCow and Sign who worked together on this. Guess what, guys? We are starting a shopping network.
Ooh.
Finally.
The Great Night Shopping Network is live, and we're going to test it out tonight. We are going to be making a...
GVN.
GVN?
Great Video Night. Yep, nailed it.
The graphics is GNS, so...
GNS!
We'll keep it...
Guns and snorts.
Guns and snorts. That's right. So we're going to make a premium shopping radio program here, but we have a lot of audio listeners here,
yep.
so we want to make sure that we do our best to describe stuff. And so actually, if you look on the stool behind you, I've made a blindfolded yep. Device. We're going to take turns selling... some items. One person is going to be blindfolded.
Yes.
With that device. How's that working, Justin, for you?
Oh, I can't see shit.
Good. Good, good, good. Matt Bryan's trying them on.
I guess I could even take off my glasses.
I guess
oh
I
my
have
goodness.
Sunglasses.
No, I'm blind.
Yeah.
There we go. Perfect.
This could be yours for only $75.
So we're going to take turns. One person will be blindfolded, and everybody else is going to ask that person some questions about the product, but the person who's blindfolded is not going to know what the product is. What it's called, what the description is, what the picture is. We will tell them the price. We will tell them the price. All right, Brian, you're loaded up here first.
GNS, you said?
That's right, GNS.
Okay, count me in as soon as we're out from an ad.
All right, 3, 2, and... Oh, wait, oh, last thing. Sorry about that, Brian. Sorry about that. This game is called Pitch Please. Everybody who's listening right now, go to the website pitchpleaseplz.com because you are going to decide who wins this game. The person who is pitching the product, you get to decide if you would buy or not buy that product based on their pitch. So
excellent.
You go to pitchplease.com and you choose whether you would or would not buy the product. And maybe you have to update your opinion over time.
Yeah. Pitch PLZ.
PLZ.com.
Just to make sure, is it pronounced pitchplease.com?
Oh, I would never tell anyone how to
okay.
pronounce it.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on. It's 2022. Jeez.
Okay,
so how cool is it that we've come full circle 13 years in the past,
sure.
and we're still doing the horse butterfly bit?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
All right, so Pitch Please.
Everybody else who saw that aged out.
That's right. All right, so Pitch Please.
Including Ed Asner.
Hey.
Rest in peace to a real one.
R.I.P.
Yeah.
R.I.P. Ed Asner.
R.I.P. Ed.
What's our first thing?
I'm loading up our first item here. This is going to be, oh my goodness, please make active. Go.
Just count me in when we're ready to go.
So here we go. This is the Great Night Shopping Network, but for the purposes of this game, Great Night is one word. So it is the Great Night Shopping Network, GSN. Welcome in. Wait, hold on. I'll be the commercial before.
Mm. Oh, yes, please.
I'm an old guy from a movie you probably saw. My life has been a real great time, but the one thing I need is the security that gold provides. Mm. Gold that I mined myself out of the hills of the family farm that I grew because I have gold. I'm a gold farmer, true and true, and you can be too. Buy my boots and my axe. I'm selling them to you when you come down to the Wild West, where gold is to be had by anybody. Rush down to oldactorsgoldrush.biz, where you can have gold the likes of which you've never seen. Show your children that they're dumb and you're smart. You never got their jazz anyway. The gold is for you, a golder's life for me, and you as well. Oldactorgoldrush.biz.
There we go. All right, we broke the website, so we're going to have to change topic here just a little bit here. So you're going to wear the blindfold, Brian. Justin and whoever's up on stage, maybe Brett, if you would like to go up on stage see this, please, that would be helpful. Because you're going to ask some questions about the product here.
All right.
But I'm just going to show them to you there. You can see... You can see that, right, Justin?
Yeah, I can.
Okay, so that's going to be the product. Listeners at home, you're going to have a fun time figuring out what this product is as well, at least for a minute.
Brian, I will scoot here.
There we go.
Oh, there we go.
Perfect, right?
Yes.
Right, right, there's perfect.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. We did it.
We did it.
Trump won.
Ooh, thank goodness it's not 2020 again. All right. Well,
Bonnie wants to know if you can spell farts quicker. Go.
We'll put a poll up in the chat so at the end of this pitch. So, Brian, you're going to have 2 minutes to answer some questions about this product. Justin and Brett, if you can help Brian out by asking him questions about his experience using this product, of course. This is, of course, lot number one today. It's
$12.96. $12.96 is all it's going to take to bring you the best. And you know that I only deliver the best. Caller, you're on the air. Hi, Brian. When you first looked at this, what were your first thoughts? Because it seems inspirational to me.
Oh, my goodness. You never forget your first. And I'd be a liar if I was to say this was my first.
Your first time looking at it?
Well, this
So you looked at it before?
Brand. No, well, I mean,
Well, how long have you had yours, Brian?
I believe 20 years.
You've had it 20 years.
Oh yes, oh yes.
I guess it's
wow. So you were into it back in the early days.
Yeah, back in the aughts.
So like back during like Kulo.
Sure. I remember it like yesterday.
Really?
Yeah.
What were your first thoughts back when you first saw it back in the day?
Why are they mailing anthrax?
Wow.
I guess that was also happening. That was happening at the same time.
Yeah.
I was probably thinking that too.
Yeah, yeah.
Brett, you got any questions?
Yeah, hi. This is Jimothy. Glad to meet you, Brian.
Jimothy, you will never, ever for 1 second doubt your purchase for only $12. Plus, this beautiful piece can be yours.
Yes, I'm really excited. I was wondering, I know that you, back in the aughts is when you first got it.
Yeah.
What three things did you want to do when you saw this item?
Yeah. I wanted to scream. I wanted to shout. And I wanted to
spread it all about
because I knew when I had a hit on my hands.
Brian, it's me. I'm still on the line.
Yeah, of course you are.
How soft?
Oh, how soft? That's a great question.
How soft?
Talc.
Very soft.
That's hard. For what this is, like I would expect. Not talc.
Well, that's them's the breaks.
All right. Last 10 seconds here while we show the audience.
Yeah, wait, hold on. Is it going down? And if it is, what would you shout?
Number one, it is going down.
Uh-huh.
And that's why I shout, take that clown.
That's weird.
Yeah. That's a weird thing to say.
You would think with this product, there'd be a one word thing you would shout if it's going down.
Tango.
That's right.
It's going down.
I'm yelling
tango.
Tango down. Yeah.
Tango down.
Tango down.
A terrorist.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is it?
I'm gonna hang up and listen.
Is it also how's it? How's it for your neck? How's your neck?
Oh, yeah. How's your neck when you use this?
When you use this.
Listen, I wouldn't be the first person to use a product for off-label purposes.
This is something about when you know Brian's improv is doomed. When he hits you with the okay, listen.
Okay, listen.
Because if there's an okay, there's a chance. If there's a listen, there's a chance. But if it's an okay, listen.
All right, that time is
listen
up.
Listen up, it's $12.95. You know you want it, callers.
All right. We've had 14 callers here in our live chat.
Oh, it's selling well.
Brian, please take off your blindfold to see what 14 people chose not to buy from you. That's going to be no point, but we were looking for the throw pillow, live, laugh, love, home bedroom, cushion pillow, Mr. Worldwide, sofa cushion, decorative square.
Does it all make sense now?
He was 12 at 9/11.
Mr. Worldwide?
No, he was Mr. 305.
He was Mr. 305 at the time.
Come on. Yeah. All the real powered 95 listeners were into it.
That's right. All right.
So close.
You were
power 96.
You're
wow,
pretty close. Yeah,
an idiot I am.
Justin, you have got the you've got the blindfold on.
Yeah,
now.
I'm locked in.
You cannot see. So,
I'm locked
Brian,
in. I just need
Brett,
to look for microphone placement.
This is the item that Justin will be selling here. This is at $15.99 here. If you could just ask him some questions here, let the premium audio shopping listeners.
Wait, actually, Bryce, can you play a little music? Is there any like music that you could bring me into my segment? If there's just like a little, like it doesn't need to be long, just like a little 5 second little stinger to bring us back. In fact, Brian, do you want to do a commercial to bring me in?
That's why Obama's great. You're live.
Hi, everybody. We're back, and boy, do we have a product that you're gonna go wild for. I can't even explain how fast these things have moved in the past. You better get to your phone right now, and you better call us. Here we go. We're taking our first call right now.
Now, hi there. This is your old pal, Mike Rowe, seller of the Cat Sack. And Justin, you're doing a great job. I'm just noticing what you're doing there. And,
well, that's great, Mike Rowe. There's nothing like being a high school athlete and having LeBron James dunk on your fucking head for no reason. It really brings me joy to know that somebody who has matured far past my station still wants to shit on me. Please talk about this fucking product.
Just want
dickhead.
To tell you, Justin, it's such a great product. I just needed to ask you a few questions about this.
Yeah.
How'd you figure it out?
Well, you know, when I first got this product, I said, what a puzzle. It was something that I just needed to get my hands on. I needed to move around. I needed to manipulate it. And it was satisfying. You want to know what? Life's a journey, not a destination. And so the more I worked with it, tactile, with my hands, moving, massaging, the better I felt it was a therapy, the likes of which I've never seen. I'm hanging up on Mike Rowe. I'm taking the next call.
Hello. Am I on the air?
Yes, you are.
Okay, listen. I've heard about this thing. I heard a lot of good things about it. But what I really want to know is it truly the fusion between power and pain, pleasure made exquisite with only you can unlock its secrets? And does it really only cost $15.99?
It is $15.99. You can buy it right now. If this involves Pinhead, then I will be thrilled. I don't know. I'm a human. Somebody involved in the process.
All right. Thank you very much. I just came three times. Click.
30 seconds left to vote. Here's a call here. How long have you owned this product?
I've owned this product for over 40 years.
40 years?
Yes.
See, you own it.
I'm somebody for home.
Sorry, I'm calling back. I'm sorry. Did you say you own it?
I sorry, I'm getting a little flustered. The lights were in my eyes. The concept of ownership is fluid in our world. Really, I mean, like do you own? When you were a child, did you own the bicycle that was teaching you confidence, or did it own you? Was it teaching you? Was it the lesson, the mountain that you climb? Do you own it because you're walking on it, or is it teaching you a lesson? That's something that I'm going to leave you with as I hang up.
Oh, click. Oh.
Hey, Mike Rowe, back.
God damn it.
Just calling back. You
just get to punch him whenever you want.
That's right.
Mike, huh?
That's part of the deal, the contract that I had.
Okay,
I just wanted
to
tell you.
What do you want
to
fucking know?
You're just doing a great job. Just wanted to tell you.
Thanks. Great compliment.
Yeah. And where would you...
You're doing great on Facebook or
wherever. Where would you I know it might be a dirty job for you, but where would you put this in
fucking,
your house?
Me. Violation of terms of service. You can't self-relate. I'm sorry. Twitch don't allow that.
All right. We all of our callers have come.
Yep. They have come.
All of our
callers
have come. We had 17 callers. Justin, take off your blindfold to see what 14 people said that they would. They would buy the Hellraiser 4-inch puzzle stash box storage tin.
Pass it on down. You're going to get it root down.
Shit.
See, here's the problem. You're going to do very well. Because we're not going to call as Mike Rowe and just shit all over you.
Yeah.
We're going to play the fucking game and try to set you up to
Sorry,
win.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm too busy here with my job.
Okay. All right.
Okay, so we're going to... Justin, Justin, could you do a short commercial so we can come in?
Yeah, sure.
Come in?
Oh, sure. Hi, I'm MC Hammer. When I first discovered watches, I said... What? But now I have a million of them. AmillionWatches.com. That's where you can own a million watches over a million months. If you have the time and the arm space, you can be like me, Million Watch MC Hammer. Just go to AmillionWatches.biz.
Hi, am I on the air?
Oh, wow. Well, I guess we're back. And thank you, MC Hammer, for all of that. We've got a caller here. Caller, how you doing?
Oh, my God. I'm so good. I'm such a fan.
I'm so glad that you called.
Like when you were in the septic system.
Yes.
Cleaning up other people's shit. It was fucking great.
It's weird. I'm Brett Weaver, and I only been in the septic tank once, but thank you.
Well,
thank
you were just like filthy as hell.
Filthy all the time.
It was
time.
Great.
Thank you.
All right, so this is lot number 3 here. This is, you can get this for
$5.99. $5.99, everyone. You know you want one. There's nothing better than this.
Hi, caller here. I have a question. Is this appropriate for my grandchildren?
Only with adult supervision, really. If you're going to be doing it, you know that this item, I mean, it's not that expensive. I mean, you can buy multiple ones if you want to.
Yeah.
But
does buying multiples of them make them any more true?
Yes. As a matter of fact, it is a volume type item. The more you buy, the more true everything is.
I yield my time to the distinguished.
Thanks. Oh, by the way, caller.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Lou.
Thank you, Lou. Thank you for calling. I'm so glad you
I was going to say, I'm such a fan. I'm such a fan, not of you, but of this product. I bought 6 of them. I'm questionable about that, number 7.
Okay. Makes sense to me. All right. Do we have another caller on the line with this to buy this great?
Hi. Who do you think you are?
Who do you think you are? Who do I think I am?
Who the fuck do you think? I'm sorry, can I curse?
Well, we're doing it right now, so.
Who the fuck do you think you are?
Honestly.
Hi, honestly, I never left. Who do you fucking think you are?
I'm just curious.
What the fuck?
Who are we? Who are we? Who do we think we are?
So I mean, you have questions too.
Yes, there are plenty of questions, especially if you buy this item and especially if you buy multiple of them.
I mean, so you think, honestly, that this is for children?
With adult supervision.
You think that this is for children? Children should be learning about this.
Yes.
Now, granted, I was in Bayonne. But this was a horrifying day. A horrifying day.
Right.
And now you're saying, children, please busy yourselves with this horror.
This is profiteering.
This is profiteering on a level. How do you live with yourself being a merchant of profiteering?
I take every day one day at a time. I have to.
You're disgusting.
Children
you're
should
disgusting.
Know the truth.
You are
the
a truth gross is the man. Truth.
Thank
you are
you.
Disgusting.
Great.
And I'm going to.
So
hang
will
up.
You buy? Will you buy one?
How much are they?
More than $5. Yeah. We know that.
Okay. What's the big takeaway?
The big takeaway is that.
What do you mean takeaway?
I like.
What do you mean takeaway?
Look.
What do you mean takeaway?
It's all.
What the fuck is that supposed to mean, Mr. Takeaway?
Takeaway.
What are we getting on the Long Island takeaway?
Yes, I am part of the new.
On the Long Island takeaway.
Are we gonna start an argument here about the takeaways?
What is going on?
Look, are you gonna bite?
I never hung up.
Hey,
in case that wasn't clear.
Yeah, please.
I never hung up.
Yeah.
I never.
Okay, look, the Super Saver is about to go to run out. I now have an accent like Justin's.
So if you're going to buy this thing to learn the truth, buy 7 of them, give them to your kids, make sure that they learn about this horrifying. I don't know. I'm just, I tend to imitate people much like Micro. Yes, Micro.
What are you doing?
I don't know. So it seems to me like this is about 9/11. Something tells me this is about 9/11.
Okay, what do you think it is about 9/11?
It is a video talking about 9/11.
Yes.
What kind of video?
Probably just the falling man. I don't know.
The falling man. Let's take a look. Take off those glasses. Yes.
All right, that is Escape from the Twin Towers, Ranger in Time, book number 11.
It is a scholastic book.
Wow.
This is a series where a time-traveling dog goes through various things, but this is for the Zoomers.
Yep.
Who were not alive during 9/11. Yeah.
It's fairly close.
It's almost as though somebody fed you fucking clues instead of doing a Mike Rowe impression.
Yeah, you posited as a Faces of Death video for 9/11.
Well, especially with the horrified grandma.
Which you also classified as fine for kids with adult supervision.
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, Bonnie.
Come on up here.
Come and sell some shit.
Yeah, Bonnie, you want to try?
Yeah, get on up here.
By the way, Bonnie,
are we getting another mic? We had
11 people vote for that, and 8 of them said that they would buy it. That's a point for Brett. Congratulations.
Hey. Woo! Okay.
So, I'm having trouble figuring out this game. So I'm listening, mm-hmm. and then I'm ignoring Mike Rowe impressions.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
I'm listening for clues, and then I'm trying to sell a product.
Yes.
Yeah, you got it.
Gold bars.
Okay.
Gold. Are they right for you?
Wait here. No, Brett, do a commercial to lead us in.
Okay.
All right. And so that's how you know it's working. Sidebar, if anything is burning, stop using the product right away and give us a call at 1-888-DICK-HURTS. Oh. All right.
And we're live in 5, 4, 3, 2, and...
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to my glorious space where I am selling to you the orchid.
Well, you don't know what it is.
Smellings. Or... Yeah, no, I forgot what these guys
did. What does it smell like? That's a great question. What does it smell like?
It smells like orchid offspring. Okay,
orchid
go ahead.
Offspring.
Well, let's take some calls.
First call. Young orchids.
Hi, am I on the air?
Yes, you're on the air, caller.
Thank you for being here. I've seen these before,
yeah.
But usually they get away. They going to get away?
They might. But I got to say, there are ways to keep them at bay.
How do you grip them?
How do you grip them?
How do you grip one to keep them at bay?
Well, there is special gloves that you can use to grip onto these items to keep them from getting away.
Yeah. Keep going.
Been cut off. I know. We got to call someone else. All right. Yes, we've got a caller here on the line. Yes, a caller.
Hi.
Yeah, hi.
I've had a problem with keeping a hold of these. Because I like a lot of them.
Okay. You've got a lot of them.
I want a lot of them, sister.
You want a lot of these.
Big time. One in each hand.
Oh, God. We got to take your special gloves.
Hold on. Do they need special gloves? Because I'm on a budget.
Oh, well.
Because if it needs special gloves, I'm out. But if it's this, if it's just the product, I might buy two.
Okay. Well, you know.
It's a party weekend.
Oh.
You don't need the gloves. You just, if you don't moisturize, then you have a little, like, extra grip. So, you know.
I love your moxie, sister. I'm in.
Okay. Next caller.
Hey.
It's Mike Rowe.
No, it's not Mike Rowe. Who's Mike Rowe? What are you talking about? This is just Kevin.
Kevin.
Hi.
Hi, Kevin.
Hi. Thanks for calling in to Orchid Fresh.
I mean, I know the joke. I know the punchline to this joke is usually 5 or 6 pounds, but I'm just wondering. Can you if you have multiple ones, can you put them all together and maybe get lift or make him work for you? How does that work?
What?
Brent, what the fuck are you?
You know, I'm just saying that multiples are always good.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm all for multiples, okay? And they are achievable, ladies. They are achievable. Okay. So.
Excuse me. Hello.
Yes.
Hello. Yes, I'm calling. Hello. With the clips.
With the clips.
Yeah.
Where are we getting the clips? Are they coming with clips? If the clips break, is there a warranty? I have a lot of questions.
Mm-hmm.
They get away from you sometimes, don't you? And you got to have these clips. And I got to...
Well, because they seem very important. They just seem very important in this entire operation. All of a sudden, like, I'm in. I very much enjoy them. But now I look at the clips and I get nervous. Why are they there? I mean, obviously, I know why they're there, but are they going to break? How sturdy are they? Where are they manufactured?
Yes. Well, I can say that these clips...
There's precious cargo in these clips.
Oh.
These clips are very important.
This is true. Oh my God!
How do you
I have a really dirty mind.
Go on.
What do you think?
No, go ahead. Oh my God! It's please, no. Tell me everything that's on your mind.
Go ahead. Go ahead, Taco Bell.
Yes. Spill the beans. Literally.
It's time for fourth meal. Go.
So, if one were to have items that get away from you and need some clipping in place, One
go on.
I would say that you could have one quality constructed item that cinches it all together, so that things don't get away.
I mean,
hold on.
I'm audio listeners. I'm gesturing. Chest region. Wait.
What? Well, no, I know. In this theatrical construct, we can see you.
Yeah, we can see you. All right.
Oh yeah. Okay.
All right. We had 19 callers.
I'll hang up and let you finish.
Hey, it's me, Mike Rowe.
Hey, wait, it's me, Mike Rowe.
Hey, it's me, Mike Rowe.
And now we do a three-row harmony.
Oh, my God, I've dreamed about this.
Everything you
dirty job.
Harmonies are usually different notes, but okay. We've got...
Not in a row harmony.
Unison can't be considered harmony.
Not in a row harmony.
Brett. Yeah.
Shut up, Mike Rowe.
Mike Rowe, shut up.
Sorry.
All right, we had 19.
Get back in my cat sack.
We had 19 callers in, and 13 of them said that they would buy this product.
Yay!
Take off the glasses and see what you were just sold. This is the Yessy Toe Chicken Harness.
It's a cock holster.
It is a chicken leash.
I was just thinking too girly. I was thinking it was a boob holster, which is also called a bra. But yeah,
so you thought all
holster.
Of them were 5 or 6 pounds?
My next thing was like going to be the strap that so you boys can go play sports, whatever that
a
is.
A cup.
Jock strap was like my next.
What was the G word you're about to
athletic
invent?
Support.
I don't know. Okay. G strap.
G strap.
I think the game's over because the prop broke.
It broke? No! Ah! My Gorilla Glue! Okay,
yeah, let me see. I'll work on it.
No, I think that's the end of the game.
Yeah, that's the end of the game.
That's the end of the game.
Thank you.
Wah, wah, wah. God, I gotta say that I was blinded there for a little bit, and I smelled something. And it was just like extra strong.
Hi, I'm my crew.
This is a horrifying.
By the way, thank you again to BioCow and Sign who made this. We will try this again in a future day when the server is working. But thank you so much for this. This was fantastic. We got to do more of this. If you've got an idea for a game, please send it to our email, greatnightpod@gmail.com.
Who the fuck won?
We all won. Capitalism won.
No.
Capitalism won.
No.
Yeah.
Bryce.
There was a
I
need you to slip that fucking result sheet into the science machine and determine who the fuck won.
Well, I can guarantee you it's probably not you, Justin.
All right, let me put the
either you or
thing in here.
I don't know. What about the societally dangerous caller that called in? Leaned into a lot of stereotypes
that
probably
right.
haven't been appropriate since the 90s. Not fucking crank yankers. The guy said internally while doing it.
All right. All right, there we go. Weird, it says everyone but Brian wins.
God damn
it. Sorry about that.
This is what happens when your first caller is Mike Rowe.
That's right. One more time, greatnightpod@gmail.com, or check the show notes wherever you are enjoying the show is where you can send in games, comments, a list of things, all sorts of great stuff. greatnightpod@gmail.com. Thank you.
I've got a consolation prize
for you, Brian. Yeah.
What?
Oh.
It's a strap for your cock.
Are you describing a penis extender?
I really wish she didn't laugh while she said it.
Bonnie is now at the humor level of 13-year-old making their first prank call.
This is true.
Hi, Domino's. Yeah, I'd like to order a strap for your cock.
Brett, what did we learn today, my friend?
What did we learn today? Well, first of all, we learned that Justin is. I don't want to go to yoga with him. I've learned that Brian really gets mad when I talk about Mike Rowe for some reason.
Because it doesn't advance the bit at all.
And then that Bonnie can hold up with her bit and likes to break glasses. And I've learned that Bryce is really patient with all of us.
Aww. Still a great night.
Yep.
Shine on.
Night.
You crazy diamonds.
Huzzah!
Just to my friend, the paint never ends the moment you walk away.
Diamond group?
That was like on the nose with the Hellraiser box. Just the
same. I was clued in.
What? Oh, how?
No, by our Weird Things conversation.
Oh, you were in the right headspace.
I was.
Yeah.
Oh, you knew that I watched right Hellraiser last week.
Extended universe.
Yeah.
WeirdThings.com.
Yeah, WeirdThings.com.
Yeah.
Get it.
The
Bonnie looks like a lawyer if you're only listening on audio. No,
there's never That's been right, a lawyer for hire. Night, a yep.
Or an attorney at law.
Oh.
Let's get See? Drunk in love tonight. There's never been a greater,
great night. We didn't reach shit.
Diamond Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.